It's like level 2 or 3, and outside that has been just fine.
Yeah, I didn't have Zillion in my list of possible Aatrox counters. I did like a lot of what happened. Issa was doing nicely in the early game, especially towards Subset. Even the Husband also survived well, but this is kind of the end of it all. Grell's gonna get ulted, but he can't really dive back in. Shogun's dominating. My goodness, Aphelios might be on track for the Penta. 3, 4, 5, give it to me! There we go, baby! That's a Penta kill for Shogun! 16!
Known that where BJ is, huge damage available. Ult's coming across, they're gonna try to burst him. Shields up, buys a bit of time, but the stun's not gonna matter. They will knock down the Lee Sin, and an escape is coming through, but the rest of the team still coming across. Ult, pretty good damage there. Will they get the pop? Yes, Shogun gets the kill on the way, and this one coming in for more with the Hexcape. Taki gets a bit low, stays alive, and it's a double kill. Oh, Shogun! Over the wall, he's drowsy. This will be a guaranteed triple kill, and it's going really good now. Only 1,400 gold separates. The crucial part is 1,000 of that.
Him, oh. Get Baron. They have to check this. Look out.
Gets ulted, gets locked up, doesn't have a single way to live. And immediately there's no jungler. Immediately there's going to be no mid laner. Chunk low, not quite dead. 5-man sleep.
5-man.
Good enough. Repose in. Huge time block, but they're diving. They've already got 5. How about the rest, though? Can they kill Fior? Yes, they can. The front line holds up. A stopwatch buys time. Xiaohu flashed the safety barely. And all they're going to get is Froggy's passive. Even that, a beautiful...
Out of Q, you have that flash. WE, neither has been ranked up just. Yep, pillar available to him. Yep, Barrett, yep, pillar, double knockup. Headbutt is going to be flashed away from Shogun.
On the tower, he's on the tower.
Stunned on the tower, the tower shot comes out. And Taki Taki turns it around. Now Shogun continues to free fire. The Carl's running for his life. Holy Phoenix cannot auto attack, cannot. He can't be in rain. The Zen is
on the tower now.
The headbutt forward. I love Vietnam, but it's the wild card.
Goes down. Topside though, PJ finds Niski. Threaded volley, looking for that work ground, looking for that work ground. One is timed out, Niski's low. He's gonna weave us all over.
That's amazing! That is one of the coolest things I have ever seen. And now a champion's that. Really don't mind going to late game. They just have to avoid the straight up head-to-head 5v5.
They also have a Baron. They have a belt. That Baron, that straight. You never really keep it on board. You have to worry about this exact thing.
It's the darkness. It's the darkness. It's the darkness. It's full of fears. But the showstopper and the blast code. That gets Taki out to safety for now. Taki stays alive for the Weaver's Wall. Two arrive. Niski will be backed up for the call of the Forge God, but nobody from Saigon dies just yet until just a moment ago. One, two members are down, but so far this fight is exactly what Saigon want. Multiple skirmishes, multiple fronts. Unfortunately for them, they're too far down.
Oh, they're not
done. All of a sudden, the Grand Starfall comes out. They're jumping on to Ornn. Kaiser's looking for the hop over the wall. Unforgiven needs to get into range onward. He's staying alive just long enough for Unforgiven to arrive, but the seismic shove of the shield bolt will force the flash out. Now Kaiser's the next to fall. Saigon ace match!
BJ!
Going on to Taki as the target. You can see if, you know, Jelly can get that flash W redirect. Hold on, no time.
Okay, it's unplayable. The matchup here in topside as maybe problematic, but again, we have Zillion ulti. We can keep on diving. There's the resurrect. But now Husmet trying to fight his way out of there. Grell, though, back in the mix. ADD, though. Now he's the one in the 1v2 again. Now played as Aatrox is popping off. That blast gun is an absolute tragedy for Isurus. And Husmet is still going, but Hecarim is far too speedy. Froggy gonna line it up, slow it down, and shut it down as Grell tries to get to the safety of the blast gun, and Froggy lasers him in the back.
Forward, there is some defense from Unforgiven. Kaiser continues to roam, so lots of movement. Fantastic prediction from Taki. Flash, dredge, line into nature's grasp, and you will not be forgiven. The fifth kill to Saigon Buffalo.
Bauer, little Zekka action, little 2v1 now on the support, barrel versus stopwatch, and not enough time anymore as Juhan's on the way over. BJ loses his shield bow. He's gonna be rooted in place. Oh, that was pretty much perfect by Froggy. Actually take a lot of it, blocks some of his ear damage, and just keeps jungler alive. Fancy plays here from Saigon Buffalo, but the end result is probably still gonna be just the one for nothing. Atonda's in, a stun, and actually, maybe they kill off Juhan. They know the ulti is gone. Gale Force auto, Shogun on the board, gets away from death, has to flash the final Mystic Shot.
Still, though, Zygon is stuck underneath this tower now, and a lot of members of DRX are moving up here. Death is in a position probably not so long.
Well, can they find the rest of it? Manages to get away from the ult. See, true shot, Brock's not gonna land, but King is in! Gets hand shook backwards. Maybe time for the rest of it. Maybe not. A bunch of people live on Saigon Buffalo.